developers of a multi-million dollar luxury apartment project at Gilberton have been forced to go back to the drawing board amid tough economic conditions. Gemma Chapman joins us live from the site with more. Gemma.
Beck, this project here at Park Terrace was touted as a world-class development key to Adelaide's 30-year plan, but it suffered a major setback. Despite the government offering generous stamp duty concessions, the developers have been forced to downsize the project because of a lack of sales. Now, in his attempt today to embarrass the government over this issue, the opposition leader has himself been left red-faced. An uncomfortable greeting for the opposition leader as he arrived at the 45 Park development site only to be confronted by the project director.
Why didn't you ring me?
Sorry?
Why didn't you phone me?
Well, it's a much broader, it's about the economic national accounts that's been put out today.
I think it would have been really good politically and from a business point of view to ring me and get my view on it, don't you think?
Yeah, it's not just about your development. There's plenty of other issues today.
The director, furious, Stephen Marshall, had called a press conference about problems with the $180 million project without first talking to him. The media conference, accompanied by the claim the development had been scrapped. That headline, wrong, says the developer. It won't proceed in its current form with 220 luxury apartments, but a smaller housing development will go ahead.
It'll probably be lower in terms of height. There'll be a fewer apartments, but all of the product will be outstandingly designed.
Mr. Marshall still used the opportunity to attack the government, which he claims has led South Australia into a recession.
Well, this project is just another example of where the government has overspruced our sector, talking about the importance of their involvement in trying to stimulate a sector.
The Premier accused the opposition leader of a political blunder which could jeopardise the project and called on him to apologise.
I think that these cheap stunts, which this one's backfired, just demonstrates how bereft they are of any positive ideas for the future of South Australia.
All investors who've already bought into this project have had their deposits reimbursed with interest, but the developer is keen to stress this project is going ahead in a modified form and he hopes to have new plans released within the next 3 months. Beck.
Thank you, Gemma.